हेलो दोस्तों, अगर आपको मेरा वीडियो अच्छा लगे तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को दबाना ना भूले।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम राहुल मापारी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन मोर क्वेश्चन ऑफ CSIR नेट एग्जाम। क्वेश्चन इज ऑफ कैलकुलस ऑफ वेरिएशन। आई डोंट नो एग्जैक्टली ईयर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन बट विच इज आस्क इन CSIR नेट एग्जाम। क्वेश्चन इज एन एक्सट्रीमम ऑफ द फंक्शनल I y of x equals to integral 0 to 1 y dash square plus 12 x y dx with the condition y of 0 equals to 0 and y of 1 equals to 1 can occur along the curve. These are the options: x into 1 minus x into e to the power x, 1 minus x into x square, x cube. So whatever option, we have one procedure to solve such type of problems by using Euler equation. I have uploaded a lot of videos on such type of problems, so please go through that, so you will get idea about Euler equation. Okay, we proceed to solve this. Now see, first of all, right here f is what? That is integrand, this one, right? So f is a function of x, y and y dash. So here, so y dash x, y. So f is y dash square plus 12xy, and Euler equation is fy minus d dx of fy dash equals to 0. This is a important equation to solve such type of problem from calculus of variation. This is Euler equation. Now this is partial derivative with respect to y, partial derivative with respect to y dash, and this is ordinary derivative with respect to x. So this gives, now f is y dash square plus 12xy. So fy, partial derivative of f with respect to y, is this considered as a constant because this is partial derivative, and derivative of this is 12x minus ddx of fy dash, and y dash is here, so it's a derivative, partial derivative with respect to y dash is 2y dash equals to 0. So this is equals to 12x minus, it's a derivative, it's an ordinary derivative now with respect to x, so 2y double dash equals to 0. So we get one differential equation actually. See here, if I divide throughout the two, throughout 2 and transfer to that side, we get y double dash equals to 6x. This is the differential equation, y double dash plus 6x. This is linear, second order linear differential equation. Okay, and you know how to solve this. So we take auxiliary equation, finding roots, then depend on roots, that is real and distinct, real and equal, complex. Then write solution and then find particular integral also, because this is a non-homogeneous differential equation, right hand side is not equals to 0, so we have to find complementary solution as well as particular integral, and then combining this we get general solution. Okay, so we have to find general solution, and then by using conditions we can find arbitrary constant and then whatever solution, right? So I solve here. First of all, this is d square y equals to 0. We have to take auxiliary equation and then we find particular integrals. First of all, complementary function. For complementary function, auxiliary equation is m square equals to 0. So m equals to 0, 0. Roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. And therefore, solution is, I can write here, because 6x, to find particular integral, it's very simple because we have only d square, right? So if I write here y of x equals to general solution directly general solution, if you know y of x complementary function is c1 plus x c2, because when we get alpha suppose two real roots and equal, we write c1 e to the power alpha plus c2 x e to the power alpha x. This, but alpha is 0 here, so that's why e to the power 0 is 1. So we get here c1 plus c2 x. This is complementary function. Okay, complementary function. Now for particular integral of this is complementary function, and for particular integral equals to 1 by phi of d, so phi of d, that means left hand side function in d, so d square d2 6x. Okay, so if I find particular integral, this is equals to, this is two times integration, and we get 1 by d. So 1 by d means integration, 1 by d, and integrate this, so we get 6 x square by 2, so we get 3. So 1 by d, this is 3 x square, right? And so we get, after integrating this, we get x cube by 3 gets cancelled. So this is particular integral, and therefore we can write general solution y of x equals to complementary function c1 plus c2 x plus particular integral x cube, right? So this is the general solution. Okay, general solution. Now I use a conditions here. First condition, y of 0 equals to 0. So y of 0 equals to 0, this imply. So but whenever x equals to 0, we get y equals to 0. So y equals to 0 equals to, I put x equals to 0 here. So we get c1, this term is 0, this term is 0. So we get c1 equals to 0. Okay. And second condition, if I use y of 1 equals to 1. So y of 1 equals to 1. It means y equals to 1 whenever x equals to 1. So 1 equals to, and now c1 equals to 0, so don't need to write here, c1 equals to 0. Now c2, because x equals to 1 plus x equals to 1, so 1, right? So from this we get c2 equals to this 1 minus 1, 0. So we get second arbitrary constant also 0. C1 equals to 0, c2 equals to 0, and therefore y of x general solution is c1 equals to 0, c2 equals to 0, we get x cube. So fourth option is correct, x cube. Okay, so इतना simple हो सकता है ये paper, तो जरूर कीजिए, तीन चार method है इसकी, और कोई भी problem solve कर सकते हैं, 8 to 11 marks contribute करता है CSIR NET में, और बहुत easy paper है. सो बने रहिए वीडियो के साथ, और भी कुछ वीडियोस आएंगे कैलकुलस ऑफ वेरिएशन के. सो थैंक यू फॉर वाचिंग. अगर आपको वीडियो अच्छा लगे तो लाइक कीजिए, और अगर आप नए हैं तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब जरूर कीजिए. थैंक यू.